Merry Christmas, Thrive family. As you know, here at Wooster Nazarene, we love this season, the blessing season. And today, I want to share with you the Christmas blessing. The Christmas blessing? That sounds like some kind of Hallmark movie. Do your mom make you sit and watch all the Hallmark movies? Let's see, this one might be where a young lady moves to a town and ends up marrying a local guy who has two kids and lost his wife five Christmases ago. The tears are already starting to come. I have no clue if that's a real movie, but it sounds like one. What is the Christmas blessing anyway? Is that when you get something unexpected? When something good happens to you around Christmas time? Or is the Christmas blessing when someone says grace way too long over Christmas dinner? Yes, the Christmas blessing. The Christmas blessing, we're going to take a look and see what it means and how Jesus is the ultimate Christmas blessing. In Scripture, blessing means to gain favor, favored status with God, or to have prosperity and success. I want that. We see it all the way back in Genesis. There's a guy named Abraham whom God called to follow him. His name was originally Abram, but we're just going to call him Abraham. And God later changed it to Abraham. And look at the first time we see God and Abraham in Genesis. It's in Genesis chapter 12. Starting in verse 1, the Lord had said to Abram, "Leave your native country, your relatives, and your father's family, and go to a land that I will show you. I will make you into a great nation. I will bless you and make you famous, and you will be a blessing to others. I will bless those who bless you and curse those who treat you with contempt. All the families on earth will be blessed through you." Wow, that's a lot of blessing stuff. Abram was chosen by God to be a blessing to the nations, that everyone on earth would be blessed through him. Okay, what is amazing about this story, and why are we talking about Genesis right now? What's amazing about this story is that not only is this where we see some of this blessing language, but it is connected to Jesus. Okay, you ask the question, why in the world are we looking at Genesis for a Christmas message? Shouldn't we be looking at the nativity stories or the Gospels? That's a great point. Let's jump from the first book of the Bible, Genesis, to the first verse of the first book in the New Testament, Matthew. Matthew 1:1. This is a record of the ancestors of Jesus the Messiah, a descendant of David and of Abraham. It then goes through this list of names beginning with Abraham, all through all these names ending with Jesus. We won't read all the names right now. But you see, Abraham's blessing of all the nations was fulfilled in Jesus. Jesus is the ultimate Christmas blessing. All the way back in Genesis, when we needed saved, when Adam and Eve made that first mistake, God put this plan in place, and Jesus came and delivered. Paul in Galatians pointed this out for us too. In Galatians 3 verse 14, through Jesus Christ, God has blessed the Gentiles with the same blessing he promised to Abraham, so that we, who are believers, might receive the promised Holy Spirit through faith. So many Jewish people of that day, they would have known all these stories about Abraham and about his grandson Jacob, who became Israel, and God's blessing over him and over the nation of Israel. While this is all true, Paul also points out that the ultimate fulfillment of this was through Jesus, and he is a blessing to all people, including those who are not Jewish, including the Gentiles. Listen to Jesus' teaching to his disciples in Luke chapter 6. Then Jesus turned to his disciples and said, "God bless those who are poor, for the kingdom of God is theirs. God blesses those who are hungry now, for you will be satisfied. God blesses those who weep now, for in due time you will laugh. Jesus says, what blessings await you when people hate you and exclude you and mock you and curse you as evil because you follow the Son of Man? When that happens, be happy. Yes, leap for joy, for great reward awaits you in heaven. And remember, their ancestors treated the ancient prophets the same way. Okay, what is all this blessing? Jesus completely turned things upside down in terms of how people thought of blessing. They thought people with wealth and food and happiness were the blessed ones. Jesus was pointing out that God cares for the outcasts, and that even though they may not feel blessed now, they will be one day. He also taught us that ultimate blessing is spiritual and not physical. This all is made possible through Jesus. God promised it to Abraham. God delivered it in his son Jesus. And God says, I love, this is my paraphrase of John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his son Jesus, the ultimate Christmas blessing, that whoever, that includes you and me, believes in him will be eternally blessed. Have you received the ultimate Christmas blessing? Have you said yes to Jesus? I can't think of a better time than Christmas 2020 to receive Jesus as your Savior. Can we pray together? Let's pray. God, thank you for the Thrive family. Thank you for this crazy year, 2020. And it's been all kinds of ups and downs and craziness. And it reminds me of the story that even in Abraham's time, when things were going crazy, you promised Jesus Christ. You promised the ultimate gift at Christmas. And you gave your son because you love us so much. So we receive that gift today. We unwrap that gift. We pull it from under the tree and we unwrap that and we say, Jesus, come, live in my heart, live in my life, be my Savior, and be my King. I love you. We pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. Man, I love you guys. I wanted to share this so much. Merry Christmas from me, Lydia, Keely, Mario, Malachi, and from all of our Thrive youth adult leaders. We all love you guys so much. Have a merry, merry Christmas. See you next week.